All right, good morning. My first video recording ever. We'll go ahead and try to capture a live trade. Made some calls yesterday, so the market's just getting ready to open here in the next minute. And we'll see how it pans out. So I just opened up. I'm already up $461. I want to do that. It's going to be a morning of big round numbers surpassed. Google above 700, Amazon above 600, and then Facebook above 100 for the first time. And the capital is on that one for about 70 points. I'm just continuing to think that that's a company whose earnings estimates are way too low. When you speak to CEOs about how to reach the millennials, which is what everybody wants, here's a dollar, Facebook, and then you get $2 back. And they're not promotional either. Both these companies, by the way, are not promotional. And Facebook's the least promotional one and has the most.
And what's not promotional in what sense?
They don't tell you how great they're being. The large companies are saying, listen, we like you more than anyone else. They just say, listen, give us a call. And in other words, they could be trumping. They usually give you a number about how many hours people are in front of Facebook versus TV. But they're not just saying, listen, we have won this. They are saying, we're just getting started. Easterbrook saying first inning at McDonald's. These guys just live to compete. They have competitors.
Interesting to note, it's funny. Facebook and Amazon's market value right now.
All right, so I'll take $132. Not as good as I thought it was going to be. But I want to go ahead and switch over to some puts.
$0.16 revenue light. The emerging markets still challenged.
Despite the fact that they remain in Brazil, and 82 hours that they get out of Brazil, the fact that they're still in Brazil, what's so funny? They are still in Brazil, and they make this much money, and the stock is down 40%. You're a buyer of World Poker. That's why we did yesterday. Stanley Black left Denver, another conference call. That was just magnificent. And now, World Poker only have to go. There's always going to be a rain. There's always going to be some short saying, this is the top, and it has, but Fentech did a good job on that conference call, and Rumble and Stanley Works, you want to go with Stanley Black & Decker, I'm sorry, buy Home Depot 124, I'm not kidding, Home Depot can go still higher, it's just
an incredible record high for Depot yesterday, American Airlines is out, they come in beat by a nickel, revenues in line, but their conference call is talking a lot about low-cost competition, and their revenue at risk, as they have to match some of these low fares.
Well, that's fair. I mean, we know that it's save and Spirit to deliver tower levels. But I would point out they have $30 billion, right? They have $10 billion in cash and a $30 billion company. They return $2.7 billion. So you let this come in, you let it come in, and then maybe you look at it. But Spirit Airlines bring down a lot. I mean, Spirit was, you know,
they cite them specifically as their biggest problem.
Spirit is just coming in as Texas rates. They're doing so well. But I don't want to give up on the airlines. I don't want to give up on it. But remember, we opened a little too high. And a lot of this is the pajama guys. They see Europe and they come in and buy some. Valiant, by the way. I don't trust Valiant yet.
I was just going to mention that, of course, what a week it's been for Valiant. It began with what some investors said, well, it seems like you're changing your strategy. Now you're going to invest more in R&D. Pipeline not going to be raising prices as much. That stock is up for the first time, I think, all week, is Valiant. They did, remember, they raised guidance a little bit, didn't they? I mean, that was when they, some said change strategy, but here it is at 116. It is seen as
all right, so all out of Apple. Back to Amazon.
I think it's just a total joke. And that there's stuff in some of the channel. I know that that's hot. I know you didn't say it, but I'm saying you can do all of those things. At a certain price, this company is just too cheap. It's not there yet. And, you know, we can laugh at Bill Ackman as a big deal, whatever. He came in and bought 2 million shares. But if he got it in between 88 and 100, that's just not enough.
Yeah, he was averaging down. Another stock that's had a heck of a week is VMware. I just want to take a look at that because we mentioned EMC earlier. In light of the Amazon and AWS and how strong that is. Where would EMC be without the deal now? You kind of wonder with VMware, what an awful week that stock had, awful couple of weeks, fall off the cliff. $57 though, first time I see that somewhat positive part on it.
They're old tech, Velociraptors.
Not in Jurassic, where they're not brought back though. I mean, they're extinct.
Yeah.
They're brought back. Yeah. Reported earnings we mentioned this morning that were low out, Amazon, Google, and Microsoft. Microsoft actually the largest gain in the stock market right now, over 10%, 10.2%. Not that far from its all-time high, about 7 or so points. From that high it hit back in 1999, when it was by far the most highly valued company in the world.
They made what I thought were outrageous promises about how quickly they could get so big in cloud. They're getting sued in 2018.
The question is, will healthcare ever come around? I mean, we got a mixed bag today in healthcare. And then you talk more broadly speaking about the drug companies, the hospital, the managed care companies.
And it came out yesterday, it reiterated even Dom.
I know. Stock was down 20% yesterday.
Yeah, the community health yesterday, they got the HMOs really badly. They came in for some of the big pharma, the little pharma. At the end of the day, with the ban on
the bed.
Defenses are, you know, they healthcare analysts don't defend anything. I mean, they'll defend, honestly, they come out every day and they defend, and it's that mirrors that money is flowing into the big multinational, internationals, and into fast tech and into PC tech. I know people don't want to believe in Intel.
All right, guys, you can kind of see where this is headed, but I'm going to go ahead and cut the video. I'll let you guys know whenever I finish up how'd I do.